The director of Tata Medical Center has done his MBBS and MD from CMC Vellore Madras University. He was also a fellow of the Royal Australasian College of Physicians and fellow of the Royal College of Pathologists of Australasia in 1985. From being a junior lecturer to associate professor and finally a director, Dr. Maman Chandy has seen all possible shades of the administration and has been dutiful while fulfilling his responsibilities at each stage of his academic career. He has overtaken around 9 research projects in fields of hemophilia, bone marrow transplantation, and thalassemia, promyelocytic leukemia, to name a few. He is an asset to the Scientific Advisory Committee. He is on the editorial board of Indian Journal of Hematology, reviewer of Indian Journal of Medical Research and National Medical Journal of India. Bengal Chamber of Commerce are proud to give away the award for excellence to Dr. Maman Chandy. I'm requesting Dr. Maman Chandy to come up on this stage, please.
May I ask Professor Sukumar Mukherjee if Mr. Kollol Dotto is around? I don't know whether he is. Can I ask Mr. B.B. Chatterjee to come on stage? And Mr. Radhakrishnan, please.
Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Dr. Maman Chandy.
Dr. Amit Ghosh and the BCCI, thank you very much for honoring me and Tata Medical Center this evening. When I was in Vellore, more than 30% of my patients came from Bengal. And therefore, when I retired, it was a great honor when the Tata Group asked me to come and head the Tata Medical Center in Kolkata. And the last 8 years have been most rewarding, because the love and affection that I've received from the people of Bengal have been truly outstanding. And it's been a great privilege for me to see an institution come up. I just want to say 2 small things. One, when Mr. Dinesh Trivedi said you need to age intelligently, I would say you need to age gracefully. And there's a beautiful film where Jane Fonda acts and Henry Fonda, which is called On Golden Pond, which you should watch, which actually shows people aging gracefully. And the second point I'd like to say, that you start aging only when you start living for yourself. So long as you're living for somebody else, I don't think you age. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir, for this wonderful speech. Now this is time for another recognition. Award for excellence to doctors above 80 years who are still engaged in his or her profession and contributing to the society. I'd be requesting Dr. Ghosh to announce the name of the awardee.
A legend in Calcutta, Dr. Kanti Bhushan Bakshi, who has serviced Calcutta's hearts for many, many years.
I'd be requesting to play a small AV on him.
The legend established the first intensive care units in northeastern India and guided several institutions in setting up ICCUs, keeping pace with recent scientific advancements. Not just a legendary cardiologist, he has been serving as the founder president of Kolkata Empowerment Foundation since October 2012, an NGO working in remote areas of West Bengal. Serving as the founder president of Vivekananda Swastha Seva Sangha, he has been working in a large community health service since 1984 and so far has worked in several hundred villages in seven districts of West Bengal. Bengal Chamber of Commerce is thrilled to give away the award for excellence to Dr. Kanti Bhushan Bokshi.
May I ask Mr. Alok Mukherjee and Mr. Radhakrishnan to be on stage, please?
And please, Dr. Kanti Bhushan Bokshi, could you please come up on the stage? Please put your hands together for Dr. Kanti Bhushan Bokshi. I'd be requesting Dr. Bokshi to say a few words.
It is really extremely, I am extremely delighted to be here this evening. And from the works of different awardees, I have learned a lot this evening. And I must convey my deep sense of gratitude to the authorities of BSSI, and particularly Dr. Obid Ghosh, for giving me this honor. I am also conveying my regards to all the dignitaries present here and the outstanding personalities who are doing extremely good work for the society. I have learned a lot this evening and enjoyed a lot this evening. What I want to say is, don't see what I am doing. See what I can do for you and the society. And I am very much enlightened for this, all the works, all the services rendered by the previous awardees. Our country is progressing well, but I must say a few words which you should know. Our country is still the poorest country in the world. Still the illiteracy highest in our country. And last year, National Family Health Survey report says that all our mothers from the age of 15 to 49, they are all anemic and undernourished. About 63% of mothers are undernourished. And the children from the age of 6 months to 2 years, out of them only 19% gets adequate diet. This is a very terrible situation. And this is making our human resource weak and the progress of the country is delayed. So I request you to think about it and think deeply what you can do to get over all this terrible situation today. Our country has going to has achieved so many things in different fields, but there is other side also to be looked after. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir, for sharing your precious speech with us. Now, I'd stay in time for a 10-minute short break. As we all know, we have seen some good ramp walk over here. And it's time for another 10-minute break where you can entertain with such a phenomenon.